Welcome, welcome, welcome to The Tonight Show, everybody. Thank you for tuning in. Well, guys, some big election news last night. Former President Trump won the New Hampshire primary. Yeah. Trump cruised to victory, and just like most cruises, half the people parted while the other half felt really sick. And, interesting. Perfect response. Once again, it's looking like Trump versus Biden. According to exit poll, 45% want Trump, 45% want Biden, and 10% said just let the AI robots take over this dumpster fire. But Trump was fired up for his victory speech. He arrived on stage riding Ron DeSantis like a horse. Come on. Meanwhile, before the votes even came in, Nikki Haley made it clear she wasn't dropping out. Yep, her campaign released a memo that said, "We aren't going anywhere." I'm not sure that slogan's gonna work. Nikki Haley, we aren't going anywhere, but not the best. She was like, "Seriously, we're out of gas money. At this point, we aren't going anywhere. We're begging for Uber pools." But get this, even though Trump had a decisive win, he was privately seething over Nikki Haley's refusal to drop out of the race and gave an angry victory speech. I'll tell you, there's nothing scarier than watching someone angrily dance the YMCA. Yep, Trump was so mad at Haley at one point during his speech, he even attacked her for the dress she was wearing earlier in the night and said it probably wasn't that fancy. And it was even weirder when Trump was like, "Strappy sandals after six? Girl, please." That's a faux pas. Some more big political news. Today, the United Auto Workers Union endorsed President Biden. Yep, they said they're concerned about his mileage, but they can probably squeeze four more years out of him before he breaks down. Meanwhile, Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau said the country is preparing for the uncertainty of another Trump term, which is a polite Canadian way of saying, "We're building a wall." Well, guys, today here in New York, Mayor Eric Adams delivered the annual State of the City address, and he started by recognizing his team of deputy mayors, but he did it in a pretty strange way. Do you see this? Watch this.
"Let me tell you something. You know, you may cut the umbilical cord, but that fluid that carries you is something that spirits you and lasts a lifetime."
What? Are there any normal leaders left anywhere? What the hell is going on? What is happening? Why? Why? I want some business news. I saw that Chipotle wants to hire 19,000 new workers to handle this year's burrito season. It's hard to believe it's already here. I still haven't taken down my decorations from chalupa season. And now, burrito season. Speaking of fast food, there's this TikTok going viral that shows a woman finding a plastic bag in her McFlurry. Can you believe that? The ice cream machine actually works at McDonald's? Well, listen to this. I read that there are plans to build the largest skyscraper in the U.S. in Oklahoma. Finally, a building for all the wolves and bears that need office space. Finally. Finally, guys, you know, sometimes you see a picture in the news that's capturing one thing but actually gives me a totally different feeling. Do you know what I mean, Higgins?
No.
Like, I will watch a... I will look at a photo, sure, and then see some... But it makes me think of something else by looking at the photo.
The photo.
Yeah, like this is a segment called That Feeling When. Check this out. First, we have a picture of Donald Trump at a campaign stop. But it reminds me of that feeling when the Benihana chef is about to flip you some shrimp. Nailed it! Next up, we have Vladimir Putin looking at his phone with some of his staff behind him. That guy on the right reminds me of that feeling when you see your boss struggling with today's Wordle, but you can't help him because he'll definitely poison you. Next, here's a picture of Joe Biden hanging with Kamala Harris. When I look at Joe Biden, it reminds me of that feeling when you're desperately trying to remember a coworker's name. And finally, here's a picture of King Charles taking a walk. But it reminds me of that feeling when being king is so boring you have to walk around the park all day flashing squirrels. That's all the time we have for that feeling when we have a great show. Naomi Watts is here. Naomi Watts is here. Michelle Yeoh is joining us. And we got stand-up from Dustin Ibarra. Stick around. We're playing charades when we come back. Come on back, everybody. Hey, hey.